gigantic. You then, stop!
Calma.
Thank you.
Yağma.
What's your pleasure today?
Christ, Megan, it's Iowa.
Commander.
Connor.
Any word on Lee?
Not yet. My apologies. I've been distracted. Supply caravans meant for the camp have gone missing. I suspect treachery. A traitor named Benjamin Church, recently released from prison, has vanished as well. The two events are surely related.
What was his crime?
He was caught sending letters to the Loyalists, detailing our troop strength. He claimed it was a scare tactic, that we might avoid war. A poor lie.
I will find Church for you.
Why? What reason have you to help?
Does it matter?
As you wish. We've received reports of trouble along the southern road. Might be he's responsible. I suggest you begin your search there.
Thank you.
Any last words? Wait. A poor choice.
Come to check up on Church? Make sure he'd stolen enough for your British brothers?
Benjamin Church is no brother of mine.
No more than the Redcoats or their idiot king.
Oh, I expected naivete, but this... The Templars do not fight for the crown.
We seek the same as you, boy. Freedom, justice, independence.
But...
But what?
Johnson, Pitcairn, Hickey. They sought to steal land, to sack towns, to murder George Washington.
Johnson sought to own the land, that we might keep it safe. Pitcairn aimed to encourage diplomacy, which you cocked up thoroughly enough to start a goddamn war. And Hickey? George Washington is a wretched leader. He's lost nearly every battle in which he's taken part. The man's racked with uncertainty and insecurity. Only look at Valley Forge to know my words are true. We're all better off without him. Look, much as I'd love to spar with you, Benjamin Church's mouth is as big as his ego. You clearly want the supplies he's stolen. I want him punished. Our interests are aligned.
What do you propose?
A truce. Perhaps... Perhaps some time together might do us good. You are my son, after all, and might still be saved from your ignorance. I can kill you now, if you prefer. Excellent. Shall we be off?
Do you even know where Benjamin Church has gone?
I'm afraid not. I'd hoped to ambush him when he or one of his men returned here. It seems I'm too late. They've come and cleared the place out.
I may be able to track him.
There were rations inside the crates. Medical supplies and clothing as well. Snow has obscured the tracks, but enough remains that we can still follow.
Just my luck. Going to freeze to death if I don't get this fixed.
Are you Ben Church's man?
Well played.
It was not wise to run.
What do you want?
Where is Benjamin Church?
I don't know. We was riding for a cab just north of here. It's where we normally unload the cargo. Maybe you'll find him there.
Enough of that.
You did not have to kill him.
Let's not waste time with all this pointless banter. Go catch up with the rest of Church's men. Infiltrate that camp of theirs and see what you can discover.
And what about you?
Never you mind. Just do as I ask.
Saw a bit of gunpowder in those crates. We'll get extra for that. My church will be pleased and we'll be rich. I almost feel bad for the Yanks, shivering and starving out there. It's a hard way to go.
All they need to do is raise the white flag.
They should have done that a long time ago. All this fight serves no purpose. The crowd should win in the end. Waste all those lives chasing the movement.
About time you showed up. Listen here. Boss wants us to try something new tonight. A raid. No more convoys. We're to steal from the Yank camp itself.
Valley Forge.
That's right.
You sure about this?
It's not my business to be sure or not sure. I just do as Church asks. If you're so concerned, take it up with him.
Is he here?
Of course not. Hiding in New York the last time, trying to keep a low profile. What, on account of him not wanting to go back to jail and all?
All right, I'm in.
Look what we found.
He was creeping around the camp all suspicious-like.
Must be a Yank spy.
Ah, he's something else. Something special. Isn't that right, Haytham? Church told me all about you.
And you should know better than this.
You're not really in a position to be making threats, are you?
Not yet.
Chocula. Hey. Man, this brother has to fight.
such as what happens when you feel good.
You'll not find better value this side of town.
I'll return half the purchase price.
Evening, Connor. I see you made it here in one piece.
Recovered from your beating, then?
Benjamin Church is held up on an abandoned brewery on the waterfront. We should be done with this by sunrise.
Good. I would like to have those supplies returned as soon as possible.
Of course. I wouldn't want to keep you from your lost cause. Come along, then. Follow me.
Tell me something. You could have killed me when we first met. What stayed your hand?
Curiosity. Any other questions?
What is it the Templars truly seek?
Order. Purpose. Direction. No more than that. It's your lot that means to confound with this nonsense talk of freedom. Time was. The assassins professed a far more sensible goal. That of peace.
Freedom is peace.
Oh, no. It's an invitation to chaos. Only look at this little revolution your friends have started. I have stood before the Continental Congress and listened to them stamp and shout. All in the name of liberty. But it is just noise.
And this is why you favor Lee?
He understands the needs of this would-be nation far better than the Jobinels who profess to represent it.
It seems your tongue has tasted sour grapes. The people have made their choice, and it was Washington.
People chose nothing. It was done by a group of privileged cowards seeking only to enrich themselves. They convened in private and made a decision that would benefit them. Oh, they might have dressed it up with pretty words. That does not make it true. The only difference, Connor, the only difference between myself and those you aid is that I do not feign affection.
Thank you.
Hold a moment. Church, you clever bastard.
What is it?
I was hoping I could wave you past the guards, but it has replaced most of them with men I don't know. Well, I should be able to pass without arousing suspicion, but you...
No. We do this together or not at all.
Then what do you propose?
I will find a guard who is off duty and take his uniform.
Very well. I will wait here, then.
Of course you will.
Oh, I'm sorry. Would you like me to come along and hold your hand, perhaps? Provide kind words of encouragement?
These men have been found guilty of treason and conspiracy. Crime punishable by...
I'm no part of it. Don't mind me.
Why does misfortune follow me everywhere?
That should suffice. Follow me.
Hold, strangers. You tread on private property. What business have you here?
The father of understanding guides
us. You I recognize, not the savage.
He is my son.
Move along, unless you want to join.
Tasted of the forest fruits, did you? Off you go, then.
It's locked. Give me a moment.
Must be strange for you, discovering my existence as you have.
I'm actually curious to know what your mother might have said about me. Always wondered what life might have been like had she and I stayed together. How is she, by the way?
Dead. Murdered.
What? I'm sorry to hear that.
Oh, you're sorry. I found my mother burning alive. I'll never forget her face as she sent me away. Charles Lee is responsible for her death by your order. And you're sorry.
It's impossible. I gave no such order. I spoke the opposite, in fact. I told them to give up the search for the precursor site. We were to focus on more practical pursuit.
It is done. And I'm all out of forgiveness.
Benjamin Church, you stand accused of betraying the Templar Order and abandoning our principles in pursuit of personal gain. In consideration of your crime, I hereby sentence you to death.
No!
You're too late. Church and the cargo are long gone, and I'm afraid you won't be in any condition to follow.
We've chosen to stand with the victor. It's Britain who will win this war. You always need to defer principles of profit. That's just why your little kingdom has started to crumble. It was a nice dream you had, but a dream is all it ever was. Look at the half-breed fight like some feral dog. Best we put him down.
where is Church?
I'll tell you anything you want, but me promise that you'll let me live.
You have my word.
He left yesterday for Martinique. Took passage on a trading sloop called the Welcome. Loaded half its hold with the supplies he stole from the Patriots. That's all I know, I swear. You promised.
And he kept his word. Let's go. Say.
Now is not the time for sightseeing. So close, yet so far. We need to find a way around the place. Back here, traitors! Oh, how I'll enjoy making you pay for your betrayal. Did Church pay you well? You were born in Hansley. And what good does your gold do you now? Is it magic gold, you think? Like the one they spun the fleece from?
Find something to pry it open. Connor? What are you up to? Oh, no. Don't do that. There's no way of knowing what's on the other side!
We do now.
Church is at least a day on us. We must move quickly if we're to catch him.
I have a ship we can use. Meet me on the pier when you're ready.
Shall we?
I told you this was a poor heading. Church is surely days ahead of us now.
Have some faith in the boy. He's yet to disappoint.
Well, the bar's not been set very high now, has it?
We are closer than you think, Father.
Ease her off, half sail. Haul everything in. No sail now, double time.
Bring her to half sail.
Haul into half sail. Aye, and she's dropped anchor.
Bring us in for a closer look, son.
It seems the ship has been abandoned.
Church always was a slippery little bastard.
Enemy ahead! They're making to flee!
After them! Full sail! To half sail!
Haul in to half sail! Bend them all, full sail! Slow her down sail. To half sail!
On my mark!
Fire!
Hurry, son! We won't get a
rogue
second chance
wind.
At this! Pull into half sail!
We need to ease off half sail!
Perhaps someone with more experience should take the wheel.
Rogue wind!
Must be saved.
What has Church done with the cargo?
Let me tell you, working my way through your nasty little tricks and traps. Clever! Some of them, anyway. I'll give you credit for that. And for the quietude with which you pulled it off! We had a dream, Benjamin! A dream you sought to destroy!
came here for a reason.
Different reasons, it seems.
Where are the supplies you stole?
Yonder. Awaiting pickup. But you've no right to it. It isn't yours.
No. Not mine. Those supplies are meant for men and women who believe in something bigger than themselves. Who fight and die that one day they might be free from tyranny such as yours.
Are these the same men and women who fight with muskets forged from British steel? Who bind their wounds with bandages sewn by British hands. How convenient for them. We do the work. They reap the rewards.
You spin a story to excuse your crimes, as though you're the innocent one and they the thieves.
It's all a matter of perspective. There is no single path through life that's right and fair and does no harm. Do you truly think the Crown has no cause? No right to feel betrayed? You should know better than this. Dedicated as you are to fighting Templars, who themselves see their work as just. Think on that the next time you insist your work alone befits the greater good. Your enemy would beg to differ. And would not be without.
Zamanios gina, the diahne de gantu titogaske.
Well, his passing was a boon for us both.
Come on, I expect you'll want my help retrieving everything from the island.
I have been reunited with my father, but I do not yet know if this bodes well or ill. Our goals are aligned, at least so far as independence is concerned. But he continues to defend Charles Lee, the man who murdered my mother and burned my village. Still, he makes a point about Washington and those who back him. I hear much talk of freedom and equality. But it seems one must be a landed white man to benefit. What if someone like me, or Suri? What role for us in this new world? Is my father right then? There is so much I must consider and so little time in which to do it.
Welcome back. And how was Martinique?
Achilles, I owe you an apology. It was wrong of me to say the things I did.
Your words were harsh, Connor, but there was also truth there. I failed the order, allowed the Templars to take control.
But now their hold is weakened, which makes me believe there's a chance for peace. Imagine what might be accomplished if we were to unite.
Why the change of heart? Where is this coming from? You've met your father, haven't you?
I do not claim to trust the man, or even like him. I would be remiss to ignore this opportunity.
Aether may listen, but will he understand? And even if he does, will he agree?
Even he must admit that we can achieve more together than we do alone.
I assume you're off to find him.
Yes. I ride for New York to see what might be done.
My brother Albigens is trying to get the other shopkeepers and publicans to band together in common defense.
Today I'm feeling especially generous.
We need to know what the Loyalists are planning, if we're to put an end to this.
I've tried, but the soldiers themselves are told nothing now, only to await orders from above.
Keep digging. Come find me when you have something worth sharing. We're so close to victory. A few more well-placed attacks, and we'll be able to put an end to the civil war and be rid of the crown.
What do you intend?
Well, nothing at the moment, since we're completely in the dark.
I thought the Templars had eyes and ears everywhere.
Oh, we did. Until you started cutting them off.
Your contact said orders from above. It tells us exactly what we need to do. Track down the Loyalist commanders.
Thank you.
Have you considered the proposal?
I'm unconvinced. To reinforce them would leave New York exposed. It's hard enough maintaining order with our current numbers. Cut in half.
Yet if we do not join with them, they risk defeat. And then what?
Well, they should have come by sea.
Well, they're talking in circles. We're nothing watching as we are.
Then what do you propose we do? March in there and demand answers?
Well, yes.
Ambush!
Connor? Little help here?
Leave the commanders alive, Connor. We can interrogate them.
Bring them back to my quarters at Fort George and see what secrets they might share. Really? Well, you'd best get after him then.
You go. I will watch the prisoners.
No, you do it.
Why me?
Because I said so. Now go.
I'll tell you anything you want. Anything, only don't make
We just have some
there.
Questions for you.
Cross that threshold and I'm a dead man.
There you are, Connor. I was worried you might have gotten lost. Come along, Ben.
Thank you.
What are the British planning?
To march from Philadelphia. That city's finished. New York's the key. They'll double our numbers, push back the rebels.
When do they begin?
2 days from now.
June 18th. I must warn Washington.
You see? That wasn't so very difficult now, was it?
I've told you everything. Now let me go.
Of course. The other two said the same. It must be true.
You killed him. You killed all of them. Why?
They'd have warned the Loyalists.
You could have held him until the fight was done.
What? And waste precious time and money on their care? What would be the point? They'd given up everything they knew. I'll meet you at Valley Forge.
For the widest assortment of dry goods, feed, and other staples, call upon the good folk of Lund, off Carter's Lane. If your joints excruciate, ears sight.
Yama.
Should be sharing what we know with Lee, not Washington.
You seem to think I favor him, but my enemy is a notion, not a nation. It is wrong to compel obedience, whether to the British crown or the Templar cross. And I hope in time the Loyalists will see this too, for they are also victims.
You oppose tyranny, injustice. These are just symptoms. Their true cause is human weakness. Why do you think I keep on trying to show you the error of your way?
You have said much, yes, but you have shown me nothing.
have to remedy that, then, won't we?
Sir.
Hello, Connor. What brings you here?
The British have recalled their men in Philadelphia. They march for New York.
Very well. I'll move our forces to Monmouth. If we can rout them, we'll have finally turned the tide.
And what's this?
Private correspondence.
Oh, of course it is. Would you like to know what it says, Connor? It seems your good friend here has just ordered an attack on your village. Although attack might be putting it mildly. Well, tell him, Commander.
We've been receiving reports of Allied natives working with the British. I've asked my men to put a stop to it.
By burning their villages and salting the land, by calling for their extermination, according to this letter. Not the first time, either. Tell them what you did 14 years ago.
That was another time. The Seven Years' War.
And so now you see what happens to this great man when under duress. He makes excuses, displaces blame, does a great many things, in fact, except take responsibility!
Enough! Who did what and why must wait? My people come first.